Just mention him. Well, I didn't mention him, actually.
See,
I didn't actually mention
him.
Never know.
Did you say hello to all them? There's a fella called Hector Gray down there.
Ah, Hector and Larkin.
And Larkin Burke.
And Martin. And he's the laughing cow. Look
Martin
at Martin.
Martin Walton up there as well. Be the laughing cow.
God bless him. And you see,
and Leo McGuire. Leo McGuire.
And Fergus. Yeah.
Sorry, can I hold that up,
oh,
please?
Jenny, mate.
Do you know what that is?
Was that ours, Eddie? Well, thanks be to God, somebody got something out of it. Because apart from me wages, I never got did you get a brick, Jack? I would have loved Louis to give us
that's
a brick.
That's why I got that.
That is the key of the number one dressing room in the old Theatre Royal. That. And they've all handled that down through the years from time to time. How did you get it?
Well, the very minute the show was over, they were going for souvenirs, and I went for the key of the number one dressing room and for Jimmy Campbell's baton. And I looked for it today, and it's put away too safely, but I have that as well. I have Jimmy Campbell's baton that he conducted the last show. I played the last week there that it closed. I got the key, and the other souvenir is from the old Queen's. It's the centerpiece of the balcony, you know.
Show Noel what you have in the little box.
And this
down there
is from, God rest his soul, Ursula was kind enough to present me with this. That's the Great Jimmy O'Dea shawl and his blouse.
Jimmy O'Dea's shawl and blouse.
Yes. I'm very proud to have them, I must tell you.
Now, which shawl is that, Cecil?
That's the Biddy Mulligan shawl.
The Biddy Mulligan shawl, yes. That is the actual one, is it?
Yes.
And that is the blouse.
And that's the blouse.
And did he leave you those, Cecil?
Well, Ursula said he always intended me to have them. Is that right, Ursula?
Yes. Ursula, there she is.
She was very kind to remember me and present me, and I think they're marvellous.
Yes.
Because he was a wonderful performer, a wonderful man, and I'm delighted to have them.
You should be. Ursula, why did Jimmy want Cecil to have those now?
A great admirer of Cecil's.
A great admirer of Cecil's.
And Noel's.
Yes.
And all comedians.
Yes.
And comedians.
Yes. Very good. Well, that is very sad, but for God's sake, Cecil, you must keep those. I'll give you back your key in a few minutes because I don't know who you're going to give them to later on, but however. Let's have a look at three pieces of film that Noel has starred in down through the years. Now, there are a million and one of them, of course, but we have six altogether, and we'd like to show you three of them now. He did extremely well, particularly in the Watch Your Stern sort of carry-on series. This isn't actually called a carry-on, but it's called Watch Your Stern, but it was one of these, and you can roll it there, Jan, and in this, you'll see Mr. Noel Purcell being very officious, while Kenneth Connor plays a spy, all dressed up, and Ted Ray's son Robin is in it too.
Good evening, Sergeant.
Good evening, sir.
This lady with me is Miss Potter from the Admiralty. I dare say you saw her when she came in.
No, sir, I only came on watch a few minutes ago.
Oh, I see. Well, Miss Potter's coming with me to Admiralty House. Will you see she's given every facility during the present alert?
Aye, aye, sir. Come in.
Miss Potter, sir.
Ah, Miss Potter. Good evening, Miss Potter.
Good evening, Admiral. Something wrong?
Oh, not at all. I must apologize. You see, you are not quite what I was expecting.
No.
No. I'll explain later. Do sit down.
I suppose you thought that all we lady boffins were just female dragons.
Well, I certainly never expected anyone half as attractive, if I may say so. That's all right, Flags. I'll look after Miss Potter.
Aye, sir.
Have you the creeper plan with you? I mean the acoustic torpedo Mark II.
Yes, here.
Captain Foster tell you about the flap we had this morning?
Oh, yes. Terrible.
Yes, of course, I saw through the fellow in a flash. One of those faces you don't easily forget.
Really?
Mad, staring eyes, fanatical, you know. But he won't get far. MI5 have been warned. Red security alert all over the command. Dockyard clamped tight.
I wouldn't like to be in his shoes.
He'll be shot at sight if he makes a run for it.
Shot at sight? Mightn't that be a little dangerous?
Damn it, madam, the man is a spy. Not in uniform. When you put on a disguise, you become a spy. Deserve to be shot on sight.
Oh.
But never mind, Miss Potter. Cheer up. Don't worry your pretty little head about that spy. The plan is in safe hands.
Oh, yes.
May I press you to a drink? You've had a tiring day.
You're telling me. I mean, you're asking...
You seem to do well in them seafaring pictures, don't you?
Peter O'Toole saw that much of the picture when we were in Hong Kong doing Lord Jim. And we were going out to see the town with Tom Cavanagh, who was the boss of the fraud squad there then. And he looked at the goggle box and he saw this being run off. So then he had enough and the scene was over and they went on to something else. And as we were going out, says he, hey, son, says he, who did the talking for you? Says, oh, I can speak, says I can speak English when I want to, you know. I said, oh, yeah, I read a book once.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's a new day for milk lovers with a new milk called Dawn.
Good morning to you.
Creamy tasting.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Dawn is rich in flavor.
Good morning. Good morning to you.
It's nutritious, naturally, and with a name like Dawn.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Which comes so fresh with the dew.
Good morning. Good morning.
New Dawn says...
to you.
There's a revolutionary sweetener that tastes as good as sugar. Canderel. It has no saccharin and no bitter aftertaste. Just like sugar. Canderel. The revolutionary sweetener that tastes as good as sugar.
Have you done your road work? You gotta keep your left up and say without any reply. But straight on Kellogg's Bran Flakes, that's a different matter. Here's where they all comply. They're tasty, tasty, very, very tasty. They're very tasty. You gotta try a left hook followed with a right cross. Have you seen the guy you gotta beat? But straight on Kellogg's Bran Flakes, that's a different matter. Here's where they all agree. They're tasty, tasty, very, very tasty. They're Kellogg's Bran Flakes. They're very tasty.
When you're doing it yourself, do it right. In a multi-purpose pack, every fortnight, first you get a project guide with ideas to keep things out of sight. Drawing, so you'll make them right. Know-how, so you'll understand it right. Second, you get 8 technique cards, so you'll drill it without cracking, and they're always at hand, day or night. Third, you get an up-to-the-minute buyer's guide, so you can see what does what and choose it right. It all adds up. When you're doing it yourself, do it right. All right.
There's a lighter, brighter world to play. So enjoy your chocolate the lighter way. Maltesers. Maltesers. Honeycomb center, crispy and light. Real milk chocolate in every bite. There's a lighter, brighter world today. So enjoy your chocolate the lighter way. Maltesers. Maltesers.
New Ivory Shield, with its deodorant stripes, keeps a body cool beautifully.
Get Peugeot 205X appeal from Noel DC Cars Limited, Commons Road, Cork.
Invest with Irish Nationwide Building Society and grow a little richer every day.
These are the eyes of a well-known personality seen frequently on RTE. Identify the person and you could win yourself tickets for The Late Late Show. For full details and an entry coupon, see this week's RTE Guide.
All right, let's
see you in another Seaford movie now. This is one of the Doctor series, which are always hilarious. You can roll it there at Jan this time. And this is a delightful little vignette, I think, as Mr. Purcell doubles over and gives problems to Mr. Dirk Bogard.
Well, was that the
piece? Next! What might I inquire is the matter with you?
I'm stuck.
Stoker Coble, sir. Says he's stuck.
Stuck? Stuck. There I am, Doctor. Stuck in a way, good up. Minding my own business. Well, suddenly I get stuck. Just like this. Look.
You mean you can't stand up straight?
No.
What we of the medical fraternity call a sloppy disc, eh, Doctor?
No, it is, Easter. Easter, go and stand round. Hmm? Now, look. You come. Hurt?
No. Can't feel clean.
You feel that?
Yeah, it tickles.
Oh, Easter, get him. Come here. Get underneath and take the strain. Now, look. You push up and I'll try and pull, right?
But...
shall I get the chief engineer to fix up the block and catch him?
I don't think that's necessary. Come here.
Hey, Doc. I'm not going to be left this way for keeps, am I? You know, the wife will think I'm taking the mickey out of her.
No, you'll be right in a jiffy, I promise you. Easter. Mm. Easter, give me some oil, will you? Rub him down with. This knee's loosening up.
We've got some castor oil.
Castor oil, olive oil, imbrication, anything will do.
Thank you. Miss Mellet pinched the olive oil for her bang de soleil, as our French friends say.
Good morning, miss.
Thanks, Doc. You fixed me fine.
Now, who was the bird there, by the way? Who was the lady?
Bridget Bardot. It was our first picture in London. First picture in English, in British studios, I mean.
Well, no wonder she sort of caught your eye, generally.
Well, she had a young, very young husband with her. So that the other actors, the young actors, or any of the fellas with the roving eyes had no chance because he was going around there with a 14-pound pain hammer in case anybody even looked at him. The actor would say, you got the wax treatment for looking at him.
That actually happened to Noel one day.
What was that?
I remember, if he remembers, we were in the Royal walking away and he was over in Mulligan's and he was running across the road and suddenly he got locked. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah.
He got locked. And he's in the middle of the street, you know, and he can't move. Can't move. Be back. Somebody had, do you remember, fibrositis?
Yeah. Sean Mooney brought me home, took off me clothes.
That's right.
Yeah, he's there. Yeah.
Sean Mooney is up there.
He was in Mulligan's at the time.
You're not escaping yet, Sean Mooney. Don't worry.
He had to put you to bed that night. You
did too. I was threatened to fall down.
Bent over.
I never felt a thing.
Bent over. Yes, Eileen, what?
Sean brought him home, got him up to bed. Got him undressed, because I was only this size, you know, I couldn't do a thing. And he was just, everything was fine. I said, oh, thanks very much, Sean, and Sean left. And then he knelt down to say his prayers. And he couldn't get up again, he got up again. And I had to run after Sean and bring him back to get him up.
I remember that, in your record.
Yeah.
Roaring for help.
Lumbago.
It was like mixer. Jack Lewis.
Oh, yeah, up
Jack
the door.
Jack Lewis.
I noticed that you sort of get a little emotional when you see these old movies. You fill up a little.
Here he is, well, I had legs then.
You had legs then. Well, now let me take you really far back. Really far back this time. And I don't know, you'll have to put a date on this, because it was a movie directed by John Ford. And it was way out west. You can roll it there, Jan. And this is a very, very young Noel Purcell as a school teacher. And Alistair Sim plays the part of the rather stern-faced priest. It's Captain Boycott.
It's a queer, neglected spot, this land of Mayo, that's been left tagging behind in the footsteps of progress. But it's your inheritance. It's been yours since time began. It's been handed down to you by your forefathers. And although somebody's got in between them and you for the last couple of centuries, it's still yours. Get that into your heads. Nature has given you a priceless birthright. She has endowed you with wealth beyond the dreams of avarice. Well, maybe she's been going a bit easy lately. The crops of 78 and 79 weren't too good, and this year's doesn't seem to be a whole lot better. But that's just the contrary way with nature. And look at your compensations. Look at your landlords, if you can find them. I've taught you to count. Then count, aye, count the 20,000 of our people that have been thrown off their farms in the last 3 years because they couldn't pay their rents. But can you count pain, hunger, suffering, wretchedness? No, you can't. Well, leaving you to digest the historical importance of what I've been telling you, that concludes the lessons for the day. We're going on a walk tomorrow, picking a few flowers. Maybe we can find out what's wrong with nature. We're starting from the schoolhouse at 9 o'clock. Any of you living near Kong can gather outside Jack Donovan's pub there at 10. Good afternoon, Father.
Would that be history or geography you were teaching them, Daniel?
You're a father, you could call it a bit of both.
You're shifting about a bit, aren't you? The last time I was here, it was the Sahara Desert you were giving them.
It was a wee bit dry for them, Father. I came home.
And in the history, you'd only got up to Henry VIII.
Oh, we skipped him, Father. That's not the class of a man you'd want to tell young children too much about. We had no books for some of the fellas came after him. So I thought I'd pass over a few years and bring the whole lot up to date. Yeah,
but modern history has its pitfalls.
There's no man Father knows better where they are than myself.
I can see that.
Besides, did you ever hear me tell them anything that wasn't the truth?
No, Daniel. But you might happen to have a way of presenting the truth which would leave it a bit lopsided. We've enough trouble in this generation without stirring it up for the next. Did you hear that Captain Boycott was handing out eviction notices?
I knew what had happened, Father.
Wattie Connell is out serving them now.
Father, it's a long step from serving the notices to throwing people off their farms.
It may come to that.
I hope not. The thought of the violence it has led to in other parts is enough to put the heart across a peace-loving man like myself.
Now, Alistair Sim, Frank Launder was the director of that. I'm sorry, I got confused with the thing that I have later on. Frank Launder was the director there, but do you remember making that, of course, very
yes,
early?
Yes, we all did. Eddie was in it. Mm. Eddie? No, Cecil wasn't in it.
Albert
Sharp. Yeah. Bar of the town. Yeah. Yes, Albert Sharp. Was Albert in it?
Yes, he was.
Yeah, because we made it down at...
Stuart Granger.
Yes, Stuart Granger. It was... One of the few pictures that Colonel Kelly wasn't in.
He's hiding his head there. Never mind.
He was an honest God soldier then.
Yes, Colonel Kelly, sorry.
Shake hands with the devil. And we were on location at Ballymore Eustace. And a very small car came down the hill and the boot opened. And your man was wrapped around the boot, inside the boot. How he got into it, I don't know, because it took us about a half an hour to get him out of it.
Now, yeah. You had a story about him with a part in an opera.
Oh.
With the DGOS.
Yeah. I was a bit jealous of the late Joe D, who got a part in Seraglio. Di Stefano was singing Tosca with us, and the place was crowded. Standing room and all gone. And he said, Bill, I want to see this opera. I said, there's only one way you can see it. And that's by being in it. So we dressed him up as the Cardinal. And I thought he'd get a laugh when he came on, but he walked on. He was a massive figure as the Cardinal with the mitre and the staff. And he walked on there. But he got by that way. That's how he saw the opera. And that was his first appearance in opera.
Yeah, I was dressed in the punters, 4, 6, 7, and 5.
Yeah. I'm giving them a tic-tac.
Now, Noel, straight enough, everybody obviously makes mention of your great height. Has it been an advantage or a disadvantage, do you think, to you?
Oh, no, I think it's always been an advantage. It isn't an advantage to a comic, because all the good comics are all handy-sized fellas. You never see great comics. Yeah. Over 6 feet.
Yes.
No, because
that would be no
great comfort.
Celebrity in the Royals.
Oh, God, yes, oh, God.
I mean, bigger than anybody else.
Yeah, well, it was the only one you could recognize, you know. 3,680 people. You walked on the dress suit, they didn't know who you were. They instantly recognized your man. Could be Jack, Cecil, and myself, you know.
I'll tell you a good story that's very true about him one time. He was going to do a monologue, he was going to do an impersonation of Billy Bennett. So he said to me, have you got one of them monologues of Billy Bennett? I said, I have. It's a bit long. He said, I'll tell you what I'll do with it, Cecil. He said, I learned the first few stanzas of it, write the rest on the blackboard, and you get down into the pit, hold it up. I said, fair enough. So we opened a Sunday night. He said, is the blackboard ready? Yes, give us a look at that. Oh, yes, that's all right. Yes, the whole lot's there. Now, it's when I come to... she swam out to Sydney, he swam out to Sydney on his floating kidney. I always remember this. And then back to Alsac Lorraine. When he hit the pier, the wife said, I'm here, so we dived in and swam back again. Now, that was the cue. So I goes down, I didn't think it'd be any bother at all, but there wasn't a light in the place, and I fell over drums, fell over trombones and everything, and the blackboard fell out of my hand, and picked it up as best I could, and I'm down there, holding it up, good old. On comes Noel with the big moustache. I have to take them a long time to make up. Got the hair well plastered down, the wiggers. And he comes down, he said, the opening stands there, Christmas night in the cookhouse or something, and he comes to this Alsac Lorraine thing, and swam back again, and he has a look down, and swam back again. And he said, now, that's a sample of the great Billy Bennett's walk. He said, you haven't heard the tag of it. That's a sample of the great Billy Bennett, he said, and now I have great pleasure in introducing the Royalettes. So he goes off. I fall over a few more drums and I come up. So what happened? What happened, he said? You're holding the board upside down.
I tell you what, we have some more pieces of film to show you, and we also have some people in London that want to say hello to you. Do you see, if the magic box works, I don't know whether it will or not at all. But we'll take a short break now and come back to you in a few minutes so we can make contact with them, all right? Be back with you in 3 minutes with the next one.
The late show.
Even under such testing conditions, you can trust Sure for Men. This antiperspirant deodorant now has a new, even more powerful formulation to help stop wetness and odor every time, every day, whatever you're doing. New, even more powerful Sure for Men. It won't let you down.
First, nature created butter. Then man invented the fridge, which turned out to be a little hard on butter. So Mitchelstown went back to nature and created Dairy Gold, a beautiful blend of Mitchelstown fresh cream and soya oil that spreads straight from the fridge. Who else would have thought of it? New Dairy Gold from Mitchelstown. Make it your daily spread.
When you're doing it yourself, do it right. In a multi-purpose pack, every fortnight, first you get a project guide, detailed, so you'll change taps right and condensation problems brought to light. Second, you get 8 technique cards, so you'll bend it without kinking. And they're always at hand, so you'll do it right. Third, you get an up-to-the-minute buyer's guide to see what's about, so you choose it right. It all adds up. When you're doing it yourself, do it right. All right.
There are times when you have to keep going, whether you feel up to it or not. There's nothing as bad as that stuffed-up, congested feeling that comes with a nasty head cold or sinus. Get relief from quick-acting Sudafed in handy tablet form. Sudafed, from your pharmacy only.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Farewell.
Farewell.
You just can't join our club.
Only beautiful vegetables are allowed in the Bird's Eye Country Club. Only young, slender beans. Only smaller, sweeter peas. Only tender, golden sweet corn. Only the best can join the Bird's Eye Country Club.
Goodbye,
goodbye,
farewell,
farewell,
goodbye,
goodbye,
farewell,
goodbye,
goodbye,
farewell,
farewell, goodbye.
Don't buy a van without seeing the amazing new Mazda van for comfort, performance, and economy.
Invest with Irish Nationwide Building Society and grow a little richer every day.
As a matter of fact, I wanted to clear up something. Noel has just asked Hector Gray, did he go to Navan today? You didn't, Hector, no.
No, there was a better meeting in Mary Street.
A better meeting in Mary Street? I see.
You couldn't lose any money of that.
That's known as a thinly veiled commercial, Hector. It did. When did you two first get together? I mean, how did you first meet? Hector, you tell us, please. How did you
Well, actually, meet? I suppose it's nearly 40 years since I met Noel first. And we have been more or less friends. Bosom pals, betting pals, ever since. And I have been very proud to be a friend of his, because I have found him a gentleman, a good Christian, a good father, a good husband, and a good friend. His generosity is beyond reproach. I mean, he's really good. It is very difficult for me to say any more than that. And we've had some very, very great days and nights together.
That's fair enough. There's another man up there. You were talking about the Gaiety earlier on, Joe Kearns, who's manager of the Gaiety. And Joe, Pan was saying something to me all the week about you and Noel going somewhere regularly on Mondays.
We were meddlers.
The meddlers.
That's what I... No, the meddler was a pub.
No. City Key Church.
How is it the meddler known as the City Key Church? I never heard the meddler known.
We have a riser fella, pal of his. He's a diesel engineer. Old Ned. What's Ned's name, Joe?
We used to call him.
What?
Ned Kelly.
Yeah.
And he wrote a little thing about, he called it a meddler. And it's people that go to the miraculous medal on a Monday night in season three.
Miraculous
medal. He's known as the meddler. So we were two meddlers for about 20 years.
Is that true, Joe?
That's quite true. You
went every Monday night?
Every Monday night.
I never
used... went boozing, of course, after.
Oh, I see. Oh, and what happened after the meddler? You then went on. Yes, I see. I never thought you were such a good living fellow as that, Joe.
I mean, there was no maybe. I was.
I see. I never knew he was such a good living fella either, I can tell you that. Let's have a look at a couple more movies that we want to remind you of.
Oh, no.
Are we
lined
up, Jan?
Get Sasha to
sing. That'll
be
all right. We'll get more music in a moment now. Don't lose the run of yourself. What's that?
The woman I am living with is driving me insane.
Does Peggy know it?
Yes.
You have it, Peggy. Ah,
yes.
Get over to
it.
Come on, hold the film for
I'll
a moment.
See you again, hold Sasha.
Come on, Cecil, just do it. Come on.
Cecil. We used to do it out in Tahiti and roar laughing at each other. Try to remember them.
I'm still getting the money from it.
Do you remember?
One verse, one chorus now, because all the boys in all these pubs will have these off as their own composition, so I'd like to have a chance to sing this as my own composition. Now I come home last Friday night, collapsed upon the floor, while the wife's out playing bingo with the man that lives next door. The doctor came, examined me, then turned to her and said, it's a case of malnutrition, very soon he will be dead. And now the end is near. She's drawn the blinds and pulled the curtain. She said, you're sinking fast, and now your heart's gone for a burden. Your policy's paid up, and when the man comes round next Friday, I'll just say, Sid, a right few quid is coming by. I know I have to go, for round my bed she's lit the candles, bought my last overcoat, It's polished oak with six brass handles. Although I'm skin and bone, and seven stone is all that I weigh, still it hurts. One more clean shirt and I'm on my. What is a man? What have I got? A broken nose, black eyes, the lot, and in my dreams